Okay, hi, this is Brenda Adelman, and if you're watching this video, you probably know I am the founder of How to Create, Promote, and Profit with a One-Person Show and Your Story Made Simple, and my website is forgivenessandfreedom.com, and today I am joined with my client, Pamela Ziemann. I am so excited to have you here, and you are a case study, and I want to have you talk about what's working and what you have achieved since working with me. So thank you so much for being here. And I want our audience to see what kind of rock stars I work with. So I want you to talk a little bit about your show, okay?
Oh my God, I should have worn my Alice Cooper black sparkly jacket. Darn.
Oh crap. Oh crap. I might have to have a picture with this, with that.
Yeah, right.
Okay.
So your question was,
well, I wanna you to tell us just a little bit about your show and, you know, what you do in the world.
Okay. So the name of my show is If I Were Me, I'd Know What I Want. And it's all about me doing what everybody else wanted to do. And I start off with Alice Cooper song, I'm 18, I just don't know what I want. And then at the end, it's 58. And I finally, the transition is, I know what I want. And so that's what I'm doing now. I'm working fringe festivals all over the place. I've done Seattle Fringe. I've done Minneapolis Veg. I'm going to Island Fringe and Prince Edward Island tomorrow. I'm going to Chicago Fringe and New York.
That's so amazing. You have performed so many places. Like, and when I met you, you had an idea for a show.
Right. And I used to be a real estate appraiser. Is that crazy or what?
But
I always had this feeling like I wanted to break out of my prison because I was terrified of public speaking. I mean, I couldn't speak to more than one person at a time. It was so bad. And then, so I took that job as a real estate appraiser and I worked there until like 96. And then I started gradually coming out, but I was doing communication skills training, which was okay.
But not like acting.
So boring, you know, here's the five things you need to do blah, blah, blah. And
exactly.
I impressed myself. I wanted to be like Bette Midler, where she goes from the bitch to the sexy person to the love song and express all of my emotions, be a multidimensional being on stage and being witnessed by that.
Right. And that is what's so amazing about doing a one-person show. I don't actually know any other place, any other like format where you can be the best of yourself and include all of that. And in a short amount of time, if you don't do a full-on show, you know? Mm-hmm. So what happened that, like, what was the challenge you were having in the moment that brought you my way to find me?
Yeah. My challenge was I have no clue where to begin with this. I don't have a clue, but I was going to commission a play for my dad after he died. And I thought, I want to do something in his honor to tell his story, and then it weaved all over the place. But my friend Matt Smith, who's an improv teacher in Seattle, I talked to him, and I said, where do you even start? And he goes, well, I wouldn't even begin to do anything like this without a director. Mm-hmm. And one of the things was I thought, well, I'm a ferry and a few hours away from Seattle, and there wasn't anybody. I thought I needed to work live. Mm-hmm. With this, you know, being in the theater with somebody.
That's the old way of doing things, yeah.
Exactly. And then I started Googling and I found you and I'm like, okay, you know. And then we had that clarity call. I'm like, okay. And really, basically, I just kept following my gut. I didn't know what I was doing. But when things start to fall into place, I just said, okay.
Which is what my e-zine was about today, about following your gut. And that's why everything works. I mean, everything has worked so amazing with us.
It has been amazing. I mean, ever since we started working on the show, you know, I mean, we could hardly even tell people how many things have just opened up. That saying about when you're committed, the doors will start opening. That is so true.
Oh, yeah.
I've tried and tried with other things I've done. It's just like so much effort, blah, blah, blah. But this, I mean, I've put a lot of work into it, but it's been completely fun and it's been magical.
It's been magical. Thank you. It is. It's been magical for me too, to like just watch you grow and watch the kernel of what you were talking about. You know, and you can speak, you can tell people what you're talking about, but it's so different to like grow it from the roots up and have it be this magical story that touches people that you can use your talent with.
And I think part of the reason for that is because that one quote in the Bible that says when two or more people come together on a, you know, a mission, on a statement, or, you know, something that's bigger than them, like you completely supported me in that. And I could feel it. Even when we weren't working together, I could constantly feel that you wanted the best for me and for the show. Like you wanted to get it out there in the world. And
it made me cry.
But it's so true. I mean, I am a very, very independent person and I've done a lot of stuff on my own. But this show, even though it's a one person show, I mean, there's no way I could have done it without you. And then I think about my neighbor and Bill and different people who've come along. I'm the only one on stage, but I've never felt so connected with so many people and so supported.
Yeah, it's really about having a team around you and having the support you need. And then really with your commitment level, like having everything fall into place and saying yes. Saying yes to everything.
Like some of the characters you say, oh, that'd be a good character. I'm like, no.
I know, you were resistant. Yeah, you were definitely resistant. And look at that. One of the main characters like is like your most fun character to play now.
Right. My brother, who actually, I mean, I can say I've always been afraid of him. And even though I'm 1,600 miles away, I was still like, I don't want to play him and I don't want to be on stage. But remember that one time I did an open mic? And you said to me, you said, just, you don't have to ever do it again. Just do it one time. Your brother's so far away. And then I went there and my time was up before I played his part. And I was going, whew. But then the guy just magically said, why don't you take another minute? And I'm like, okay. And then I got the chance to play out my brother. And like you've said before too, if there's anyone you're afraid of or judging or anything like that in your life, even though you're not with them, it still is a part of you.
Right.
And so, you know, like Bill was saying, like he wanted to help me through it and all this stuff, but nobody else can do it for you except you. Like
no.
I had to be the one on stage. I had to be the one with the lights on me. And that's when the healing happens.
It's pretty amazing when you inhabit those characters. And of course, my work is equally as much about healing as it is about telling our stories and changing the world with our message. Yeah.
So can I tell them this other thing that healed for me?
Yeah, please.
Okay. So remember how like our first few calls, I was like, I wanted to do the whole show very quickly. It's just like, come on, I'm from Minnesota, work ethic, like go, go, go. And so this thing about timing, I was just like,
oh, very well,
very like this. And then the last show I did, I just said, you know, healing that part of me and my little girl who didn't trust me because I was always saying, okay, we're going to rush. And I looked at some of my videos. I'm like, it's not good because I'm rushing. And so I think there's a ways to go still, but I've healed a huge part of that rushing feeling.
That's so often awesome, because that's what I was going to talk to you about next was your transformations.
Yeah.
You know, what are some of the transformations and breakthroughs that you've had?
I think that's the biggest one. There have been so many. I mean, geez, we've worked together for over a year, right?
Yeah.
So,
yeah. Yeah, well, this is the thing. We worked together in the VIP package for 6 months.
Mm-hmm.
So that was really intense and intensive of really helping you get off the ground with what you were doing, getting a first draft, for putting up 15 minutes of a polished piece, and then finally directing the whole show.
Mm-hmm.
And then, of course, having the course, how to create, promote, and profit with a one-person show so that you could go in and see. And, you know, basically what we did is work on all those things in our live sessions, you know, and in between the writing and stuff like that.
Mm-hmm. Right, so, the journaling.
I mean, there were so many breakthroughs as far as in the world, and I want to talk about that in a second, but other transformations or breakthroughs you've had, I mean, huge with your family too.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. I mean, since we worked together, my dad had died right before that. And then my mom died while we were working together. And so I don't even know where to start with that, seriously, because I know. So many things. I mean,
well, it was like, you know, you opening night during the night.
Oh, right, right. My mom died on the opening night of Seattle Fringe.
Which was a big deal.
I can tell anybody who's out there thinking about working with you that it is not about getting another client or making so much. It's like you really care about people. And that comes through so, so clearly. And the boundaries you set in the beginning, I wasn't really clear about boundaries so much. And it was just like, oh, but anybody with boundaries like you have, you can count on them to be there for you.
What do you mean?
I don't know why that is, because other people maybe don't have the boundaries. Like when the time's up, the time's up. And I'm just like, can't you go a couple minutes more or whatever? And you do.
I do.
You do.
Yeah.
You give a lot. But yeah. I'm just saying I wasn't quite used to that. And then I've noticed with other friends where they'll just like, oh, okay, whatever. But they don't have the boundaries. You yeah. can't really count on them.
No, and you can't be there 100% for people if you won't have those boundaries yourself. And then another thing with me is because I work with so many clients who also have their own businesses and their coaches and their things like that. Partly what I do is to be an example of for you so that you have those boundaries with people as well. You know, right. it's so important because I come from having no boundaries, mm-hmm. you know?
Yeah.
That's awesome. So I'm glad that mm-hmm. that's an interesting perspective. So let me ask you, Pamela, can you walk us through some of the results that you had in the world in addition to those inner, you know, breakthroughs and stuff like that?
Well, even if I never did this in the world, all the healing would be worth it. But I have been out there in the world. Like I do open mics all over the Olympic Peninsula. I mean, I've driven an hour just to do 5 minutes of my show. And so I've done that. And then I did a conference, the Veg Fest, where I did 15 minutes of my show. And then also I can weave it into a workshop after that, which is so cool.
Which is so cool. And then you're going to New York too.
Oh my God. Yeah. And I did this play. One of the first times I think I did it on stage was in Minnesota, where I actually ran for Dairy Princess, which I did not want to do at all. And I was telling my dad on stage, I was like playing the part where it's like, oh, come on, Dad, you know how scared I am of public speaking. And when I was on stage, I was so scared. And I was looking up, wow. seeing my dad, and wow. the lighting person was a big dairy farmer. And I'm just like, kind of like, come on, Dairy Princess, are you serious? It was so scary. But it's all, and then my mom was in the audience for that one. And she said, I just want to sweep that under the rug. She goes, I just want to forget about the whole thing. She felt so bad for making me, you know, encouraging me to do something I didn't want to do. But I said, this is our opportunity to heal, to own it. We can own this, Mom. And so she loved it. And I got to do that for her before she died, which was like coming full circle. Like, you know what? All's forgiven. And we needed that experience. And so that was very cool. And my brother was there too. And my brother's like, I had no idea, you know, like you had any issues. He thought he was the only one with any issues. I'm like,
that's so amazing. And that is the power of putting your work into your roles and into your play and then presenting it in front of family members. I've had that experience too, just it being incredibly healing. And like the fact that your mom got to release that also mm-hmm. on an energetic level.
Right.
Oh, that's so amazing. I have no words because that transformation is just mm-hmm. like beyond words in this world to describe.
It's complete magic.
Okay. Putting results and transformation aside, I want you to just hear a little bit about your experience. And you've already talked a little bit about your experience, but what was it like to work with me as a coach? And if you could use three words to describe me as a coach, what would they be?
Well, the first thought that just came into my mind was when I was back in Minnesota and you sent this email that was totally unexpected and everything, but the amount of support in that email was huge. So it's just like, I just felt completely supported all the time.
Thank you. So
And also I want to say, it's not like, you know, I think most of us have had coaches where it's like almost this level thing. It's like, even though we know we're coaches, but there's still kind of a teacher down here kind of feeling. It was never like that with you. It's just like, hey, we're all on the same.
Oh yeah. Cause I learned from my clients, you know, and what I love is when I have a client like you, I just like, I want to hang out with you. You know, it's like, as I learn, I grow, and we kind of can communicate at this level. That's amazing.
I wish that we could show some of the aha moments that we've had in our coaching sessions, because sometimes I can remember looking at you and you're looking at me, and we're just like, oh my God, you know, it's just like, did you just hear that? Or did you just get that? It was just like,
I know.
How do you capture something like that?
I know. It's unfortunately, I've deleted most of my videos because they're so big. Otherwise, I'm like, damn, I'd go through them right now. Thank you. That's so wonderful. So the three words would be?
The three words, I would say fiery.
That's awesome.
Supportive. But not in a weird kind of, I'm going to help you way.
I'm so glad.
Time to think about this. Empathic is definitely in there, but really creative.
Thank you. Mm-hmm. Empathic, creative, supportive, and fiery. Beautiful. Thank you. And so finally, Pamela, I'm just reading my little cheat sheet here to make sure that I get all these questions answered. For anyone considering working with me, what advice would you give them?
I would say just feel into it yourself and feel if you are dedicated to what you say you want to do. But if it's just thing like, well, that'd be nice, or probably not. But if you really want movement in your life, which takes honesty. I mean, it takes complete honesty. If you got that, then I would say there is no question about it at all. Just go for it.
Great.
I mean, I would have never guessed I'd sign up for another VIP session, because in my mind, I'm like, okay, I should get all of this. And I got so much, but then there's just unlimited potential for growth.
There's unlimited potential.
I know. And I'm jumping on all your other programs too.
I know you are. You're in all my other programs too. And the mastermind, because there is an unlimited amount of growth. I know that. So, but you know, in the 3 month, which is what I did the VIP for originally, but I may have it be 6 months, because in the 3 months, you know, you can get a good first draft of your show and 15 minutes polished. But for the polishing, I mean, 3 months or even 6 months is actually nothing. Like I spent years and years and years and years working on my show, but also you're highly committed, you know, like you're doing the work and stuff like that. And I just feel really honored that I can also offer other services that are not that intensive so that you can also get the support and the fire.
Yeah, and it's fun too. It's totally fun.
And it is fun, exactly. Because what's the point if it's not fun, really? You know, I mean, things can have moments of depth and heartache and joy within them or just on the other side of them. And that's what I'm always about, for sure. So I want to thank you. Do you have anything else to say?
Yeah, the thing that just came up to me was when I did it over at OTA, Olympic Theater Arts, I did my first time ever doing a full 1 hour. It's like, can I remember all of this? And I was so scared. People came up to me afterwards and they were just like blown away. They were like, oh my God. And so that felt really good to be able to pull that off. And it's so fun when you're doing something you really love to go deeper and deeper and deeper.
Yeah, there's so many different layers that you've brought to the table, and you're still growing. It's so amazing.
Oh, definitely.
So you worked with me in the VIP package, and you also had access to how to create, promote, and profit with the one person show. And you're in the mastermind and your story made simple and a few coaching programs here and there. What is one word that you would describe for your experience?
Awesome. Awesome. I hate saying awesome. It's so overused.
But I say it so much too. Awesome. I do the same thing. I say it, I write it, and I'm like, I wish I could say something else, but that's what it is. Oh, great. That's great. And why don't we put your website out there in case anybody wants to go to it? And like, maybe they'll be in an area where you're performing your show.
Yeah. All my shows are listed on the show link, and the website is PamelaZiemann.com.
So awesome.
PamelaZiemann.com.
Great. Well, it was fabulous to have you here. Thank you so much. And for anybody watching, I would love you to be my next success story for sure.
And if anybody wants to reach out to me and say, hey, you know, tell me about this or this or this, they can or email me, and I'll, you know, if they have questions.
Yeah. That's awesome. Please reach out to Pamela, reach out to me. And that's great. Have a wonderful day. Thank you so much for taking your time with me.
Yeah, thanks.